Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today we will be discussing the characteristics of a Mahdavi, a true Mahdavi. So what should a Mahdavi be like? First and foremost, to be a Mahdavi, one must accept Hazrat Sayyid Muhammad Jaunpuri as the promised Mahdi alayhi salam. If you want to keep your name and identity in the community of Mahdavis, then you need to truly love Allah. If you keep Allah before everything else, then you can keep the right to be called a Mahdavi. If you keep a good heart and good kinship towards the Mu'min, the believers, then you can consider yourself as a Mahdavi. You should not be scared to stand up for the truth against the disbelievers. Then you will have the right to be called a Mahdavi. The person who suffers through struggles patiently for the sake of Allah and steps into the biggest battle, which is the battle with your nafs, your desires, will have the right to be called a Mahdavi. Don't be scared of the ones who criticize you, who use their voice and power to bring you down. If you stand up against them, then you can consider yourself a Mahdavi. If you have all these qualities, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed you with these qualities and He blesses whomever He chooses, then you can call yourself a Mahdavi. We need to establish all these qualities. We have to adopt all these qualities to be called Mahdavis. In this time and age, people are becoming egoistic. We are not going against our nafs, our desires, but instead, we are becoming the slaves of our nafs. There is no longer a love for Allah, but a love for everything besides Allah. Now, the Mahdavis, the most superior community, the most pure community, if they start getting lost in the worldly things, then nothing but humiliation will be left in their destiny. Mahdi and the Mahdavis will be there till the day of judgment. This is for sure, as said by Mahdi alayhi salam. But everyone has to procure their place. Allah has made us a part of such a great community, which teaches us that there is nothing greater than doing everything for the sake of Allah. Salah should be read for the love of Allah. Then that salah is considered an actual salah. If we are giving zakat and we are getting rid of the love we have for our money and are increasing the love for the one who gave us that money, Allah, then know that the money you have taken out as zakat has gotten accepted. What does tarke dunya mean? Tarke dunya is getting rid of the love we have for the worldly things. And if you do it for the love of Allah, then consider that you are getting the true benefits of tarke dunya. Sobat is-sadiqin, which is the company of the righteous people, staying away from the liars and hypocrites. If you are really being in the company of the truthful people, then you are going to be improving yourself with the qualities that they have, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help continue to guide you in the rightful path. If your love is truly with Allah, then it blossoms you. And if your love is with anyone or anything besides Allah, then it degrades you. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum.